Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1719, Return from Select Precedents. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Today's question is sent in by Mark. He talks about using an old trick that I first learned from my friend Howard up in New York City, where you can turn off allow editing directly in cells and double click a cell, and instead of putting it in edit mode, it shows you all of the precedents. But first, let's talk about the keyboard method for doing this. We have this cell here, which is referring to several other cells. If you press Ctrl and the square left bracket, it will select all of those cells. And then Mark goes on to say, the only way that he's found to get back is to press F5 and then Enter to go back to the original cell. And he's trying to figure out a way, since he already has the mouse in his hand, to have a one-click way to go back. All right, well, first let's talk about the keyboard way. Maybe we can just get Mark to stop using the mouse. If you do Control left square bracket, it'll select the precedence, and then Control right square bracket will go back to the original cell. So there we have an easy keyboard method to select the precedence and then go back. But let's say that we want to do this with a mouse. So File, Options, Advanced, uncheck this box, allow editing directly in cells, click OK. Now when we double click the cell, so you're using the mouse, double click the cell, it selects all the precedents, and you can even go to the keyboard and press Enter to loop through each of those precedents. But to go back, F5 and then click OK. So is there some way to write a macro that will do F5 OK? Alright, so we're going to switch over to VBA here, Alt F11. And I wrote this tiny little macro, I call it GoBack, and we're using a feature that is much maligned because it is not reliable, but here we're just doing two keys and I've tested a few times. It's called application.sendKeys, and then in quotes, we're sending it F5, that has to be in curly braces, and then an Enter. Alright, so we'll switch back once you've added this. We're going to add a little function to our Quick Access Toolbar, right-click, Customize Quick Access Toolbar, look under Macros, and the go back macro. You can change that icon, of course, but I'll just click OK. And so we'll double click the cell to select the precedence, and now click the go back to go back. Boy, it was so fast. On a slower computer, you can actually see the go to dialog box appear there. So a couple of cool tricks that most people don't know about. Control left square bracket to select all the precedents, Control right square bracket to go back. If you're a mouse person, you have to turn off the allow editing directly in cells. That way the double click will allow you to select it. And then, of course, either Control right square bracket, or if you want to continue to use the mouse, the little go back macro. All right, well, hey, I want to thank Mark for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.